They just know about going to church. And they pick up a little piece here, and a little piece there, and a little piece over there, but they don't know what they're believing in. You see? So I'm going step one, step two, right? Move on me, baptism. Now we speak about baptism, believe in the baptized, but baptism in many different cults or many different denominations, they do it differently from the Bible. Is that all right? When I was a good woman, my parents sprinkled my head. The priest did that. A little baby, we had something they call a Christian. So they took me to the church, and I didn't know when I reached and when I came back out, because I was a little baby, and they sprinkled my head with some holy water. And they said, you're not old Christian, we call that baptism. Is that all right?
Yes.
Well, I didn't see that in the Bible. Is that all right?
Yes.
I've been baptized another time again. But God is going to invite me to the church, and he took me down to the river, and they hit the one dot for the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Ghost. But that was my name, they never called a name.
Amen.
Are you still there?
Amen.
There was no name, but I got baptized in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and the name of the Holy Ghost. Well, the name ain't called yet, so I think that baptism was null and void.
Amen.
Amen. But when I read here in the book of Acts 2:38, it said that you must baptize in the name of Jesus. In the name of
Jesus Christ.
Could you quote it? Could you quote it? Acts 2:38. Anybody have it yet? Repent, each and every one of you. Amen. And be baptized in the name of
Jesus Christ.
Why? Why you must baptize in the name of Jesus Christ? And not in the name of the Father, Son, Holy Ghost, and not the sprinkle some water of here. Why you must do that? So much big religion doing that. Well, the Bible said that the name is the highest name. The name of Jesus is the highest name in heaven, on the earth, and under the earth, that things bow. Everything bow at the name of Jesus. You know why? Because the name Jesus is the name of the Father. Are you still there? Are you still there?
Amen.
That's why Jesus said, whatsoever you do, do it in my name, calling on the Father. Are you still here? So you do it in the name of Jesus, calling on the Father. Amen.
Amen.
And it shall be given unto you. Whatsoever you ask, ask it in my name. Are you still here? Ask it in my name. Whatsoever you do, do it in my name. Paul went on to say, down in the New Testament, he said, whatsoever you do, do it now all in the name of Jesus. Are we still here?
Yeah,
amen. Are we still here? Are you understanding?
Amen.
So everything that a believer does must be in the name of Jesus. Because the name of Jesus is the name of the Father. You want to know where that is? In John 17. In John 17, he said, Father, I've established thy name on earth amongst men. And John 17, study John 17 as your own. Father, all those you have given to me, none is lost except the Son of Perdition. He said, and Father, I've established thy name, own name on earth amongst men. Now we still here. Amen. So the name of the Father, Jesus came to establish the name of the Father on earth, that we have all access to the throne of God out through the name of Jesus. Are we still here?
Amen.
Are you understanding?
Amen.
That's why he said, I am the way. You could be the way. I am the way. If you come after me, you'll go to the Father. No man cometh unto the Father but through me. Through me. Through the name. I've established that name. That name is a guarantee that the Father is going to hear you. Are you hearing me?
Amen.
The guarantee that the Father is going to hear you is in the name of Jesus.
That's why people tremble
and they're afraid of the name of Jesus. Yeah. The power and the authority is in the name. Yeah. God has given him a name which is far above every other name. Any name that you could call on earth, there is no power in them. Jesus, you call power.
Yeah.
Angel power, that name. Things in heaven, power, that name. Things on earth, things in good. You and me, things is you and me, we on the earth, and things under the earth, all them creatures on the earth bow at the name of Jesus. All the creation bow at the name of Jesus. Amen. So you then have to understand. You find hard to understand what you mean. Yes, yes, yes. All right, bless God. Yeah, bless God. Anybody find that hard to understand? So why you didn't understand it before? Good revelation. Good revelation. Is that all right? So you see, you need a revelation.
Amen.
That's what the apostle is about. Those who run before, God never gave them revelation because their call is not real. They cannot unfold the word of God. Are you serious? Are you understanding tonight? This is the reason why I came for to teach. To disciple you. Are you still in? Not just to teach you about the of God, but to disciple you. Are you still in?
Amen.
So that you, in other words, will be able to do what I do by the same Spirit. Is that all right? When I just started off this ministry, I discipled. You could never have a ministry without having a disciple. Are you still here? And Bible school doesn't make you a disciple. Because Bible school is always run by denomination. And every denomination has their own standard. That's why they call them denominational standards. I've been through 3 Bible schools and that. That didn't make me any difference. Just like a secular school, I went to school. I study with pen and paper. Is that all right? But it didn't make me any better. You can go to Bible school and come out just like you went. Is that all right? Yeah, like you went to secondary school. The Bible school. Amen. The fact is, if you don't have the leading of the Spirit of God, if you don't have the revelation by the Spirit of God, you are wasting all your life and all your time. You know what dead preachers come in? I call it the cemetery. They call it the seminary, right? And I call it the cemetery. Many, many dead preachers come from their places. Yeah. And they have big congregations and everybody there. They're dead, they're everybody dead, everything there. Because the Spirit of God is not there to give it life. Are you understanding?
Yeah.
So I believe that the humble servant, just doing God's will,
yeah,
as simple abode. And I thank God for this. We are in one of the most simple places. I was then classified by Jesus, born in heaven. So we have an amazing experience. The only thing, we got no sheep and goat and sometimes cat and no dog. As a matter of fact, when we were building that pulpit, I left and went down the road to get some things for the kingdom. When I came back, there was a big pocket money. It's my way to get in there. He walked straight in and went straight up to the pulpit. You understand? No, God works with signs. God works with signs. We have experienced so much signs and so much miracles that God is moving. You don't have to question that. You know, we don't have to question that. We know that God is with us.
Amen.
We are doing His work. The whole heart, whole mind, whole soul. Because I gave to God everything. When I gave to God, I gave to my family first. I gave to Him all the material things that He blessed me with. Which was none when I started. When I had a whole car, I gave it to God. And it was the worst car on the road, all the body rocked down to zero. And all the police and others come up in my foot. And they said, what happened? You know, pastor? All the pastor brand new cars and I got out. As you are going there, ready to get me there. Yes, you are going to need them, take a box of matches. What is this? But the goodness of God is with you.
Amen.
I said the goodness of God is with you.
Amen.
I can testify of it for the amount of things that have been in my life. Is that all right?
Yes.
Amen. So baptism. Different types of baptism, denominations. But the true baptism and the real baptism is by submersion. You're going under the water. Some people like to leave a tip of the head and that's it, go under the water. Because it's symbolizing something. I would say it. You are telling the world and the witnesses around you. And the Bible said we are compassed in the book of Hebrews by so great a cloud of witnesses. All those that have gone on before us. The Bible said they cannot enter in with others. So they are waiting and they are watching and what we're doing. Is that all right? If we do it right. Amen. So when we say we're going down to the water to be baptized, all the hosts of heaven is watching.
Yeah.
Amen. They are witnesses. And all the people that come to see what's going on, they are witnesses. Amen. So we are testifying now that just like Jesus died on the cross, and he was buried. Are you understanding why we go into the water? He was buried. But he rose again on the third day. Amen. Is that all right?
And
the Bible said that we were justified through the blood of Jesus. Amen. He was buried. And he rose again on the third day. Are we still here? So we are now telling all the witnesses, that our life is now crucified with Jesus. Are you hearing me?
Amen.
Paul said, I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I. The problem with believers, they want to live this life and still want God to live in
you. Yes.
Are you still in?
Yes.
But the new birth, the Spirit of God that's in us, enables us to live pleasing unto God. And His word that we read and study comes alive in us by the Spirit. Are we still here?
Amen.
Because the Spirit feeds upon that word. Are you understanding? Are you still here, sister?
Amen.
The Spirit feeds on the word. The word of God is the food of the Spirit. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Are you understanding it? The Spirit comes alive when you become that word. Are you still here?
Amen.
The Spirit comes alive in you as that word is applied, not to your mind, not to your mind, but to your soul. Is that alright? The mind is the gateway. Are you still there?
Yeah.
Your mind is the gateway to your soul. Amen.
Yeah.
So that everything and every thought and all influences come through your mind first, and then it's filtered into your soul. Are you still there?
Yeah.
So your soul have two sides. Only get so quiet.
Yeah.
I said your soul have two sides. One is called the dark side and one is called the bright side. You over here? You heard that? No, I don't hear. Yeah, right. That's why we are in class to understand it. Once it's associated to it. Alright. So the dark side, when you choose the influence of darkness, it overpowers the influence of the light that's in your soul. Are you still it? So that it spreads more to the other side, squeezing out the light. Are you understanding? That's when you make demonic influences. Diabolic influences. I was telling you, when you accept evil rather than good, amen, it squeezes out the light. In other words, it fills your soul with more space for darkness. The Bible said that men rather darkness rather than light because their deeds are evil. I was telling you, men rather darkness rather than light because their deeds are evil. I was telling you, but when you accept the light, and you accept the word of God, or the life of God, it pushes out the darkness. Are you still here? Are you understanding what happened right now? I say, are you getting someplace now? Are you understanding what happens? So it pushes out the darkness. So the darkness has no place. So that evil is conquered. I said, so that the evil part of you is conquered by the light of God. Are we still here today? Are you understanding? Amen. And this is the power that God has given us. That we can call upon the name of Jesus because we have the authority. He lives in us. That's why the Bible said that your body is a temple of the Holy Ghost. Are we still here? He said, know you not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost? Amen. For the Holy Ghost dwells in you since you accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Amen. So we can squeeze out the darkness. And just have light over me as we live righteous. As we live the right word of God. Are we still here tonight? Come on, give the Lord a good clap of praise. The Bible said that the devil will have no room. No room, no space in him. Amen. Let me go into that. We go quite a lot of John chapter 3 and all of it. So read about all of that, right? But we ain't going there. We ain't going so far. All right, we have time, we have classes coming up. Amen. Are we satisfied?
Yeah.
Are you happy with the teaching? Yeah. Happy with the yeah. I don't want to take you away the other time. Oh, I didn't make it watching a very long time, but it's still working good. Yeah. I just taking it and put it in the box. I see it taking me good. Somebody see it 10 tonight? Pass. 10 past 9? All right. I won't take too much longer. All right. See how much it has in the morning. Anybody imagine? 3 and 4. Amen.
Yeah.
And on and on and on. Now I told you all I'm taking it from the beginning. Is that all right? Which means this is a class until you manifest the Son of God. Are we still in? So it's a class for all the church. What you can't hear in the congregation when there's deliverance. I would say, this is a deliverance ministry. So you cannot get what you're supposed to get in deliverance. You just be delivered and delivered and delivered as long as things happen to you. But what happens to these believers that they see have to be delivered all the time is that their soul, their dark side, is more than the light side. Are you still here? Amen.
Yeah.
So they have to be continuously delivered, not realizing and not understanding the word is what will deliver.
Yeah.
Are you hearing?
Yeah.
The word is to deliver. He sent his word to heal them and deliver them from all of their sorrow. That was clear.
Yeah.
The word of God. But the more we understand and study that word brings deliverance to us. As we begin to live it, the darkness is driven out more and more. So you receive your deliverance, you receive your healing, you receive your miracle by the same word of God. Why? Because that word is Jesus. Are you still here? That word is Jesus manifesting in you. Amen. That's why the Bible says, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Are we still here? Greater, you have greater because you're having more and more and more and more and more. The enemy prophet saying, give me more. I need you more. More than yesterday, I need you more. More than words to say, I need you more. I need more of Jesus. More of his word. More of his ways. More of his spirit. Come on, somebody. I need it. More of his character. I need you more than yesterday. What was good for yesterday? Ain't good enough for you today. That is still food. Yesterday food was still food. I wouldn't have no fridge to put it in. The only fridge you can put in is if you like cool and indifferent. Oh, it remained dormant.
Yes.
Are you still here?
Yes.
So you have to be vibrant. Yes. You got to be receptive. Yes. You got to be on fire. Yes. Loving the things of God
yes.
more than the things of the world. Are we still here?
Yes.
That charisma is going to get that word deeper and deeper inside of you.
Yes.
So you see, we have the second part of 1 and the second part of 2. Amen. So we pause there for tonight. Amen.
Amen.
Next week, we are coming for the third step. I can let you revise and study the third step. The third step will be from the book of Romans, chapter 8. Because I did not feel the message. The third step. Praise Him, somebody. Hallelujah. So, we can't go back anymore. If 10,000 come, we still can't go back. Okay. Only study the whole Roman day. Amen. Because there is, it's going to get so excited when you understand who you are. You're either physical or spiritual. But you're getting there at the same step. Are we still here?
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Are we still here?
Amen.
Are you enjoying this, guys?
Amen.
Well, I won't tell everybody. Everybody come. Everybody come. Come and get a stick. This thing is good. We're getting to start the grass by the weeds. I think we're stepping up from the main stage. Alright? We're stepping up from the main stage. Stage one was bait. Stage two is baptism, conviction. Come on, somebody. Are we still here? And stage three will be the growth of the Spirit. Are we still here? Roman days. Alright? So we're going on. Amen. And I could tell you stage four, we're going to the gifts and the manifestation of the Spirit. But I don't want to give you that yet. Let's go with this. Let's go with this. Yeah. Is that all right? Let's go. Amen. Praise the Lord. So we get that right. Let's close off tonight.
Yes,
that's how you got to go. That's how the word of God is sweet. The Bible said it's sweeter than a honey. Are we still here? Yes, I've always known to be a great teacher, way back then. So I like the excitement and the enthusiasm in the Word of God, studying the Word of God. That's all I'm saying.